So now with Steel Blue up to Google Frog, I'm not sure how. Like, Feltas and Google Frog, kind of more of an even matchup, but Steel Blue and Google Frog. Sheesh, if Steel Blue can pull that off, I'd be amazed, but I'm not sure. Like, Steel Blue. Steel Blue has actually lost to Google Frog. Google Frog put Steel Blue in losers, now that I think about it. So Google Frog and Steel Blue. Now, this is kind of a revenge match for Steel Blue. They were put into losers by Google Frog 2-0. And now they're in a position where they're basically. What are they even doing here? Like, they're gonna have a really tough time here. The only thing I could maybe see being possible option would be. Because this match is going to start up on Wanderlust, I believe. So from there, I guess they could go for something a bit cutting. Like, how would they do in Wanderlust? It's not a very cheese-friendly map. Yeah, they're going to have to play solid on that. And Google Frog solid play is probably more solid. But we'll see. I mean, if Steel Blue manages to at least pull in, it's going to be tricky. But Steel Blue has actually had a really easy layout so far. I mean, they had a buy. Like, Parzival buy, and then they lost to Google Frog. And then exploit. I mean, they cheesed out Feltas. And they recovered it, which is actually a sign of a good player. But now against Google Frog in a best of three. So we are on Wanderlust. Which people seem to forget is Wanderlust V01 in order to actually play the map, because it's not just Wanderlust. That map's an old map, which is not played. So this is going to. Oh crap, I forgot to actually put Losers Pre-Finals. I'm sorry. Well, it's Losers Finals anyway. Kind of in this weird haze of all these random games happening. And the game is beginning with Steel Blue and Google Frog going at it. The Losers Finals will be. Oops. We'll be beginning right now. So Google Frog is. Let's see. Google Frog is going for Cloakybot. Steel Blue is going for Cloakybot. Steel Blue going for an early economic lead. They don't want to have to deal with anything to do with, well, a military cheese. Interesting. I still don't see how that's going to help them out too much. Like, they're basically playing Google Frog in their own game. They are taking Google Frog's favorite expansion, though. It's the easier one for Google Frog to get to. But I don't know if that's really going to matter. Google Frog didn't go for a northeast start, so it's not that big of a deal. Like, a center-eastern start makes that north area a bit safer. Welcome back.
I'm back now. Thank you.
So yeah,
I'm with you. I really don't agree with this decision by Steel Blue. He's playing Google Frog at the long game. I don't think it's going to work out well for him. He's taking this northern side, right, like you mentioned, and it's just so easily taken by Google Frog that he'll be dislodged quickly, I think. Yeah. I don't even think he'll be able to hold it.
It's just, how do you cheese in this map? Like, I can't think of any real cheese that works. Other than...
Brawler cheese on this map.
Yeah, factory-related stuff.
Yeah.
Not something you can easily recover from.
Yeah.
Like, nothing like the Scorch one, at least that's recoverable, because Altair Crossing is a flat enough map. Mm-hmm. But Brawler? That would be death.
Yes. Yeah, absolutely. That's an all-in there.
Mm. Oh, we're probably close to metal.
Google Frog's moving into the central position with his commander. He already has the Glaives running around, picking off the few scouts that Steel Blue is sending out, so... The military advantage is Google Frog's pretty handily already.
Yeah, that means the economic too, because they're probably going to easily get the plus. Yeah, they're going to get the plus three expansion very soon.
He hasn't sent any glaives up north yet, and he actually hasn't picked up this radar or this constructor on his radar either. So pretty lucky constructor there.
Yeah,
but
very close too. Still, I mean, Steel Blue has the economic advantage right now. They need to translate that. They need to put production on that.
Yes, absolutely.
And they need energy on that too. And where is their commander?
Up north,
commander's
just sort of
idle,
hanging out.
Well, that's game.
Just yeah.
You're against Google Frog. Your commander goes idle. You've lost.
Yeah, that's. I mean, that's really true. Look at how active Google Frog's commander is. He's out here in the center of the field taking this high value.
Yeah,
mechs.
At the same time as a worker's over in the northeast taking those mechs, and another one's in the southeast taking those mechs.
Yes. and a third back at base building energy. Beautiful. So, beautiful long game setup. Google Frog knows that he doesn't really even have to worry about the Raider game here because of how decisively he won early on. So he's put down some light defenses and he's just expanding. He'll steamroll Steel Blue pretty shortly, I would imagine.
Yeah, I think now Steel Blue's commander is going, but like I said, it was idle.
Yes.
That's all that needs to be said. Not to mention, the factory itself is not being used that much, and there's no construction of any energy, even just linking the grid completely.
Although Google Frog needs energy himself. He's at 14, 16 now. He was at 9 just a few seconds ago. So he actually, despite having such a large metal income, didn't have very much production.
That's Google Frog style, though. Google Frog actually taught me basically to do that, which was you start off getting a bunch of metal extractors, and then you basically build power right about the point where you'd start, where you'd actually excess, but yes, you don't actually excess, and then you just burn all that storage right all at once.
And he timed that perfectly. His energy came up just as his metal storage was nearing the full point, but he didn't excess at all. So it was exactly what he did. He did it beautifully.
Yeah, that is something Google Frog does, and Google Frog taught me to do, and basically, as far as I know, Google Frog considers it to be essentially optimal play, because you just defer the build power. Like, you get the build power later, but unless your opponent goes for some timing rush, which 0K doesn't really have early game timing rushes of that nature, you aren't losing anything.
Yeah, and plus, you get the, of course, the metal more quickly, which is the really limited resource.
Yeah.
Pretty sneaky pack of Glaives trying to head through the south here. It looks like they'll get headed off.
Although, the Defender, one of them is... so close to actually killing the Defender. Got a little bit too timid.
But there we go. This pack nice over the southeast. Doing nice. Yeah.
The lack of light defenses is starting to bite Google Frog slightly, but not as well as I'm sure the Steel Blue would like.
Gets the LTs up just in time to stop this from heading further into the base. It could have been ugly, but nice response there by Google Frog, of course.
Now, Steel Blue, they have the economic advantage, but they do not have production. They have no workers on here. They have no caretakers on here. They've got nothing to work with.
We've got just one
about to access in about 3 seconds.
One worker coming up. Yeah, they're accessing now 20 metal every second this continues.
That is painful. Ouch. Already they've lost 2 glaives.
Yep.
That was like 5 glaives.
Like you always talk about, once you get past, you know, basically a factory's worth of production, a lot of players glaives. Mess up. Yeah,
like I'm just counting the seconds. Like every 3 seconds, that's a glaive they could have made,
and it could have been a military advantage. Like this is the difference really between Steel Blue having a chance and Steel Blue being steamrolled, is accessing raiders like this.
Yeah, the fact that they basically could have had about an extra 15 glaives in this army. I'm not kidding. Yep. It was 45 seconds around roughly.
Ouch.
And now they're going to be able to make up for that somewhat. I mean, not completely, but they're at least going to be able to get that up, so at least have the local advantage.
And burn through the storage. So, yeah, they should get a nice little surge here in the center, which would be really exactly what they need.
Oh, no, they can. Their commander's on point. They're okay. Good. Yeah, they're pushing 40 in.
Line up. Oh, if he can thin this out, he can charge into the commander. But no, Google Frog's too smart for that.
No, there's too many Lotuses. If there were a couple of warriors with this pack... Not Rockos, but Warriors.
Sure.
That would do the trick, because that would stop the Glaives, that would get through, that would tank everything necessary to be tanked. And Glaives going around the back, but once again, double Lotus. Google Frog, they're being careful.
I wonder why Steel Blue is building Rockos here, knowing that Google has an almost pure Glaive composition.
Bad route. Either they're probably trying to kill the commander directly.
Because
Rockos do an exceptional job against killing commanders, and also the Lotus. The Lotus and the commander is just...
Anti-port.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And also it would help is maybe to preempt a warrior switch since, of course, Steel Blue is so glaive heavy himself.
My first guess, but that's clearly a bad read if that happens, and there's good reasons for that to happen. Like, there's good reasons to go for a Rocko that had nothing to do with reading a warrior.
Yeah, that's a good point.
I actually don't see a lot of players even go warrior that often. It's especially the high level. It's not a super common unit.
Well, the mobility is just such an advantage if you're a high-level player.
Yeah, if because, you can micro the glaives. If you're winning the glaive micro wars,
exactly. It's just
if you're losing the glaive micro wars, then you definitely want to have a warrior.
Yeah, warrior is almost a crutch, like a recovery tool. If you've really messed up the raider game, you build a warrior and try to equalize. Yeah.
It's very handy, but it's just not... I think a lot of high-level players think, no, I need to go for the glaives as long as possible.
Right. Yeah, these Rockets are doing beautifully to push through the pork. That's exactly what he needed.
And that
You don't really want to dive the commander with these glaives at all, since it has that riot cannon.
Well, if you spread, If you spread around it, it'll kill two and die.
Oh, that's a good point.
And as long as you spread them away in the death explosion, then it'll work.
Thunderbird coming in here.
Oh yeah, that's actually a miss.
Not a great hit. Those things are so hard to use. And these blades are going to come up and clean up the Rockos, maybe?
Yeah, and now there's even more glaives. Steel Blue has nearly double the military. I mean, now that they've managed to push their economic advantage into a production advantage, those 15 glaives have essentially been made up for.
What is happening right now?
That... I don't know. Just enough numbers in enough spots that local advantage has won out. And Google Frog loses their commander, killing six more glaives than necessary in that death explosion. But still, that was... This is a very powerful switchover. Okay, this is a problem. This Thunderbird, is a problem.
Mm-hmm.
But Google Frog's not out yet. But they are pretty heavily damaged. Hey, this isn't good. That northern expansion, I think that's the main thing. Steel Blue had plus 6 metal on top of Google Frog for the longest time.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that might have actually made the difference. And at this point, Steel Blue...
Look at all these glaives.
They have a lot of reclaim, too.
Just running past this expansion from Google Frog. Same deal, a naked expansion to the south. It looks like, every once in a while, it looks like one glaive's going to wander into sight and pick up maybe the radar.
Down here.
So fragile. But.
And the Rockos go down, but to no avail, because, frankly, they don't care. Glaives beat Rockos anyway.
Really, the Rockos' job is done. Having taken out the commander, I mean, they might be useful for pushing into the port, but if...
They need them. Steel Blue needs the Rockos to get through the defenses.
Yeah, but he has more than enough right here. But if he can just continue to pump out glaives like this, he should be fine.
Yeah, I just think that at some point, I think we're going to either see this Thunderbird get a good shot off or Warrior Switch.
Actually, we're seeing a Napalm Bomber being built up right now. Which
also a very good option.
Yes, but however, Steel Blue is preempting this and already trying to deal with the Thunderbird as well.
Oh, the Gremlin. Good response.
Gremlins.
That's good that they're focusing on that. Because, yes. I mean, they could just think, Thunderbird one-off, I'll just avoid it. But no, it's not a one-off.
Yes, don't underestimate the Thunderbird.
And it looks like the South expansion has been spotted. Steel Blue is aware of it, but a bit too late.
That's right. Not as easy to clear out now.
However, the North expansion is also not naked. It hasn't been naked for a little while.
Wow, this is turning out to be much more of a game than I thought it would be.
Indeed, you were all going about Steel Blue being stomped, and I wasn't sure, now I'm really not sure. What the heck? What's going on here? And Gremlin, will it take out the Thunderbird?
Uh-oh.
No, I think the Google Frog is going to turn it around. That was
so beautiful.
No micro at all.
Oh my gosh. No, and these Rockos are so clumped. These glaives are arced beautifully. This is...
Steel Blue is still ahead. I think
still
a lot
ahead,
of commander.
No doubt.
How much of that is commander? Okay, if you discount the commander, they're even.
Wow.
And Steel Blue's ahead economically.
So Google Frog, he's looking to raid out right now since he knows he has a huge military advantage. He's also checking out a couple of constructors to get all of this reclaim on the southern side. He's managed to hold onto the southern side pretty well. There's 3,000 reclaim here. And just keep these glaives in position is my advice for Google Frog. And take all of these constructors and just reclaim.
Yeah, it looks like that'll actually get... Oh yeah, Google Frog's at parity now. But at the same time, we're not seeing Steel Blue being a slouch either. They have reclaim going as well. Okay, one of their conjurers is idle. Once again, idle conjurer is death. And the warriors have been built up. So we do have a warrior just to help deal with that. And when you consider that Steel Blue has the military lead slightly, that's saying a lot. It's basically just there to finish everything off. But we do have the Napalm Bomber coming in, which is a little late now.
Thunderbird just a little bit.
Thunderbird on the warrior.
Wow. Perfect.
Once again, another set of dead army. Like, this is enough.
Those Rockos are done, and look at that. Those glaives taking out that warrior like nothing.
Yeah, this is actually enough, I think, to put Google Frog back on the board.
Wow. Look at that. What an excellent comeback, though.
Oh, yeah.
It was looking so ugly for Google Frog.
But that's the thing, is that it's just... They were losing, and I was about to say, they need to kill two armies to get back in the game, and they've killed two armies. They're back in the game.
Yeah. Yeah. I really hope Google Frog wins, so I don't end up being wrong.
I kind of hope Steel Blue at least takes a game, just that it doesn't look like all they can do is cheese.
Yeah,
but I think at this point, they've earned our respect.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, definitely I have to eat crow for all the things I said. early on.
Oh, cloaking mix up, but in two ways, Steel Blue loses down to Scythe. Ouch. Exposes a gremlin position and loses, well, loses a gremlin ultimately, and loses a conjurer. Why are these Swifts back here though? Steel Blue's had about a minute's worth, 2 or 3 minutes worth of Swifts, and they haven't taken out anything that Google Frog has.
I think he's trying to like keep it a secret, but that's really only something you do with like a commander sniper or something.
That's
once you're about to engage in a full out, you know, air suit battle, you usually just go for it, you know.
Also, especially that's you keep a secret until you need it, and I can't think of any better time to need it than when your entire army is about, it would be stunned if you didn't do it.
You definitely don't want the Thunderbird to say, come right now and stun out all these warriors, so he should definitely be flying over, and Google Frog spotted out the Swifts anyway.
Yeah, just sides. Go.
Just go.
Because if they go, the Thunderbird won't stun everything. If they don't, it will. It's about to. All this stuff here, the only reason it hasn't been stunned yet is because it's not quite a threat due to the fact that the Rockers can deal with it, but soon will be. Like, sooner rather than later, so just, I don't know. I mean, they don't know the Scythes are here. That, or they just aren't paying attention. I mean, what are they paying attention to? Okay, they're entirely on the front lines.
Yeah.
Like, they have...
Dealing with this...
They're not going back to base, and that is costing them. That's actually been the thing that Steel Blue's been doing. Like, they've been strategizing well, they've been building good unit compositions, they've set up their expansions where they need to. They just haven't been attentive. It's just been the thing that's differentiating the two, is attentiveness.
Yeah.
And that's something that Steel Blue has been, like, they've had idols, they've had... Now these Swifts that are just, like, all... There's 19 Swifts, and none of them are doing anything. Well, one of them is. 18 so Swifts, much... none doing anything. One of them is actually being useful in scouting.
There's, like, 3,000 metal in Swifts. Man, that's such a waste.
2,700, but yeah.
Yeah.
One of them just died.
Sure. But, yeah, totally. I mean, it could be doing so much. It could be cleaning up these Rockos, these Swifts.
Well,
they have
moving,
no problem with the Rockos.
Where are they moving now? They're moving out-ish.
Up to the north?
Maybe. Mm. But yeah, they could clean this. They could clean house. Why are they not doing that? I mean, these Glaives from the south could also, but then they can't really deal with that Lotus set. Like,
yeah,
Google Frog's
like,
locked down the south side.
Yeah, well, absolutely. And then he made sure to reclaim super fast. Look at how much of that reclaim is chewed through already. It's almost all gone.
Oh, yeah, that was 3,000, now it's 500. No, not even, it's 400.
So, these Glaives are going to try and charge into the Rocko line, but...
Well, if they hit the
Rockos
right side,
so
if they hit one of the sides.
Yes, if they can get around to the very edge.
Sort of.
Like it's broken. Oh.
But where's the stun? Where's the Napalm Bomber?
This is a massacre.
Why is Google Frog not killing them? What the heck? Where's the Napalm?
I'm
so confused. Okay, there's the Thunderbird.
A little bit late.
Yeah, a little bit, you think? That was most of Google Frog's army that just got wiped. That disarm would have been useful about 10 seconds prior. Like, there's what? Half a dozen Rockos left? Out of like, 2 dozen? And now we have a shield switch on top of the air switch. For
also
ball.
A crab switch. This crab is actually up from Google Frog, so this is probably where the reclaim went.
I see. But that's going to be... Wow, it's another 2 minutes? 5 minutes? Wow, the economy is just tanking. They don't have enough to really push that, do they?
Well, they already have the one out on the field.
Oh, they do. Never mind. Yeah, that's the second one that's not doing well. I missed that one. Good call. Yeah, Glaives going down again, but only the Glaives. And now
Google
the
Frog
Thunderbird goes down.
Finally. I was just going to say, Google Frog is showing what you can do with one Napalm Bomber and one Thunderbird.
When your opponent decides that they don't want to take air superiority for themselves, even when they have it.
Yeah, exactly.
It's like, oh yeah, I have air control. I should enforce that, shouldn't I?
Mm-hmm.
Although the Glaive survived. Looks like none of them died. So at least that worked out. But still, that crab is going to be a slight pain.
Yeah, definitely going to clean up the warriors well.
The warriors, yes. The Glaives, however, should be able to take it.
Yeah, unless they, unless Steel Blue blunders here and clumps them too much, in which case the splash will clear them all out.
And I'm not sure that that's not going to happen.
Yes.
Although thugs,
nice
thug attack in the south. That's good choice.
But it looks like no outlaws. That's unfortunate. You usually want at least one so you can slow the LLTs down to 50%.
Mm-hmm.
But it doesn't look like the thugs will have any trouble.
Well,
until
not
they get
the LLTs, but yeah, everything else coming in afterwards is going to be a bit of a problem.
Yes. Oh, these warriors creeping along the northern side here. Napalm bomber coming to try and deal with them.
Flanks along the side. Yeah, the napalm bombers won't do much.
It's going to get intercepted by these Swiss too. Should.
Yeah. No. It looks like the Swiss is going for ground support.
They just pull back. Oh, harassing the crab. Oh, they might actually be able to take it out. What's this crab going to be able to do against the Swiss?
It can fire and hope for the best.
Yeah. Maybe we could get lucky, and if they swarm right above it, and it's just sort of miraculously hit.
It's not even trying. It's actually high enough that they're using the missiles on it too.
Oh, really?
Looks like it. Yeah.
Yeah. It looks like these Swiss are going to take out the crab. Just 28 HP
Bam.
Left.
Defender takes. Defender kill steals.
Look at that.
So that's. Wow, these turned around again. Steel Blue taking out the south side, Steel Blue taking out the north side, Steel Blue taking out this entire expansion with just a handful of warriors. Like, that's good unit composition.
Snipers out from Google Frog. Steel Blue's trying to screen for them, but they've been pulled back too far. Plus this crab, of course, is going to clear out the thugs as well.
Although one thing that should be pointed out is that this was a super close match with Steel Blue being almost the entire time ahead by at least 10 metal per second.
That's true.
Like, so Steel Blue needed to have a fairly large advantage in order to be on even footing.
But it was also a close game with nearly, well, over 300 elo difference. So
yeah,
I mean,
that's true.
That's certainly an impressive play there.
Just saying, it's close game with that difference, but also with the economy difference, which has carried Steel Blue. Like, that's that. And also, okay, Steel Blue... You are a man after my, or not necessarily a man, you are a person after my own heart, because you go for unit counter types.
Yeah.
Like, whatever happens, you're trying to find the unit counter to use.
Yep.
After my own heart. I do that all the time, too. Because that is such a handy thing about this game, is there's just counters. Unfortunately, they aren't quite going for them right now when they desperately need to, with the Glaives coming in and Google Frog coming into one last shot. There was a warrior here, it would be far healthier. There's a Stardust in the main base, that works. There's nothing down in the south. And all the warriors are in... Well, the warriors are in the other main base. Forcing the Napalm Bomber to burn its own base down. Like, that Phoenix is working against itself.
Huh. Oh, Steel Blue.
Go for the Caretakers, go for the Caretakers! Ah, Steel Blue's not paying attention. He needs to go for the Caretakers, take those out.
Look at this giant swarm of Glaives, though, coming over the north side. This Napalm Bomber is going to catch them, though.
Mm-hmm. But what happened to the Glaives on the south side? There were a load of Glaives over to the south side from Google Frog that have gone away. Or died.
It looks like they pulled back to try to intercept, maybe.
Yeah, they pulled back to try to deal with the Warriors. And now deal with the Glaives. That
beautiful.
Was a that was nice a Phoenix name. Shot. And another nice tick. But unfortunately, the Warriors in the back... This should not be enough. I think the Glaives will win. Yeah, the Glaives will win. The second warrior has a chance because it's retreating. Actually, the second warrior could rush in right now.
Google Frog's going to rush him with these ticks. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, there we go. Never mind.
And you could take him out with the Glaives. There we go.
But at this point, it's still double the economy for Steel Blue. And it's still barely holding on.
And Google Frog's crab is locked down by these racketeers. He does have the size in position, but he's not going to be able
they're
to
not
thin
position.
Out the
Yeah, the position
one.
Is death.
Yeah.
They're only lying down on their backs, flat, with part of their body separated from the other part's position. Not a comfortable position to be in.
Oh boy, this poor crab.
Yeah, the only thing is those glaives are kind of being wasted. Like, that racketeer could just stand there with one glaive and just peg it off over a long period of time and use the rest of the glaives to deal with the army coming in.
Yeah, that's true, but he probably doesn't want to risk this racketeer getting sniped or something.
Also, this would be a really good time to use the Swifts. Like, now, like,
yes.
5 seconds ago. That's kind of what I mean.
That's such a shame, because Steel Blue absolutely has the capacity to deal with that. He's just letting it slide.
Yeah, that's 11 Swifts. That's still pretty good. There's no additional... additional planes now being built. Just now.
And also, these Swifts can be assisting strafing the ground units, the Glaives in particular.
Yeah, now Steel Blue losing the northern expansion. Google Frog looking like they're going to be able to take this back again.
Another
and still not rebuilding. They haven't rebuilt the southern expansion. They haven't taken the south central expansion. They haven't even rebuilt inside their main base. Like, it's just a lot of rookie mistakes. That
well, you've got to imagine that at this point, Steel Blue is definitely fatigued. He's been playing against Google Frog level played for 22 minutes now and just barely holding on. I mean, between the adrenaline rush and the actually clicking
stuff.
Yeah,
the holy shit, I'm actually in game. 22 yeah. minutes in against Google Frog. Yeah. Wow.
Like,
actually, that's actually hard to get past. That's yes. really hard to get past.
So it's easy to imagine maybe some mental decomposition going on here.
Yeah, that's a common thing that happens in tournaments. That's why I mentioned earlier that reliable options are the best options.
Yes.
Because then you don't have to worry about getting every little piece right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, another blunder here is Steel Blue idling all of these constructors with all of this reclaim next to his base.
The reclaim and the static metal and the fact that rebuilding is necessary.
Yes.
Like, the only thing that's really been keeping Steel Blue in has been the fact that they've historically had an economic advantage, and also someone's pointing out that they don't have size. Like, Anakin pointing out in the stream chat that Google Frog is not having an economic advantage because they don't have size.
Huh. Yeah,
sorry,
point.
They do have size. They didn't realize they had size. So that's what I'm going to say. Yeah. They had size, forgot they had size, and allowed them to continue. And now those Swifts are just landing. Why are they not strafing? Strafing runs! Well, at this point, Hammer's going to go down to Glaives. So yeah, Static Defense has actually been keeping Google Frog in the game, I think, more than anything.
Mm-hmm. Look at how he's just saturated the central part. This, I mean, not anything Steel Blue can do from this position. Ooh boy, did you see all of those glaives go down to that
yep.
splash from the crab?
Yep.
Just what I was talking about. That crab, despite being a heavy unit, is actually not a bad riot either.
Yeah, it really sucks though that these constructors are idle. That's a huge blow. Like, if they weren't idle, I think Steel Blue would be able to have taken the south side. They would have been able to rebuild everything. They'd probably have an extra 20 metal per second. Easy.
Yep.
And the Caretaker at least is reclaiming, but even then, it's just not enough.
And now we see Google Frog is pretty solidly reclaimed the economic lead here.
Google Frog's pulling this. I think they're going to turn it around. I think the crab is too close.
Yeah, once this crab locks down the factories, or takes out the Stardust even, really, these glaives will be free to charge in. Oh, there's the second crab coming behind it. Yeah, Steel Blue is out of
options.
That is
unfortunate. It's just, it really comes down to Steel Blue didn't rebuild and Google Frog did.
Yeah, just that one last time. You can be ahead so, you know, you can be so far ahead for so long, but in the end, if you don't keep up with it for the last, whatever, 5 minutes, then you get turned around yourself.
Well, there was actually a point, I think if the Swiss were used more, it would have been a complete wipe in the main base.
Oh, absolutely.
If they had taken out the napalm bombers earlier, then the main base would be gone. We wouldn't be cast, it would be on game two, Steel Blue up one.
Yeah, I would agree with that. I would absolutely agree with that. I mean, just having so many Swifts and not doing anything with them, you have essentially, you might as well have excessed the 2,700 metal in the Swifts, you know, for every moment that they're not used. It would have been better used at least as like glaives or, I mean, anything that was actually
pretty much
some damage. So that was unfortunately a very big mistake, and I think that is a big part of what cost him the game.
Oh yeah, pointing out, Google is not rebuilding north, but they are reclaiming north.
Yeah. Well, that's a good point.
So they aren't rebuilding, but they're still getting the economy from that area.
Right.
Steel Blue hasn't been. And they rebuilt south, too. Like,
yes,
south was Google Frog's base. North was Steel Blue's.
Mm-hmm.
That's the thing.
Yeah. So just keeping it clear is a win for Google Frog.
Yeah, Google Frog has rebuilt everything they lost. And then some. Steel Blue has not even rebuilt their main base. Nor are they reclaiming much. And it looks like those constructors were pulled out of the way. Yeah, even then, I think Steel Blue is just not sure what to do at this point. Like, what do I do with these constructors? I've got so many constructors, they're just sort of hanging around.
Yep. Well, it's not much to do, unfortunately, at this point. This crab has locked down most of the reclaim.
Yeah.
There's a little bit on the hill they could get to, but too little, too late. You know, Google
no,
Fox
I
it.
Mean, like, that's the thing they could have done 5 or 10 minutes ago, because they had the constructors for a long time.
Yeah, exactly.
A sharpshooter coming up, trying to do what it can. At this point, it won't do much. That crab's going to take 3 or 4 sharpshooter bullets to kill. Assuming they hit. Oh, now it's going to take 1. If it's moving, it takes 1. If it's not moving, it takes, I think, 3 or 4. Yeah, it'll
definitely
take another couple.
An impressive endgame here for Google Frog.
Yep,
crab's sitting right on...
Steel Blue throws it in.
Yeah, well, You can't slide him for the game that he played, though. I mean, that
was... Oh, no, that was a wonderfully played game. Like, it's just,
I don't care who you are.
There are rookie mistakes, and the rookie mistakes are what did it. And like I said before, it's like, you idled, you lose.
Yep.
That's just because that's how close it is.
That's how... Yeah, exactly. You just... If you're going to keep up with Google Frog, you really have to be on that level. But still, I mean, definitely impressive work. Wow, Google Frog actually accessed 2.8K. Steel Blue only accessed just under 600.
Really?
But that was towards the end, of course. It was towards the end that Google Frog started accessing.
Earlier, didn't they? Like, they accessed for almost a minute.
Steel Blue did.
Yeah.
Earlier on. Yeah, but then Google Frog started accessing its reclaim.
Right, yeah. That's true. But still, 600 metal is 10 glaives, so. Or 9 glaives.
Mm-hmm. Very early in the game, of course, where it's a huge deal.
Yeah, so just give me 1 second. I need to take a small eating break.
Sure. Yeah, you bet. Just waiting to see what the next map choice is going to be. See, Red Comet or Geyser Plains. Interesting. Geyser Plains. I hope we see Geyser Plains, and then I hope that we see a hovercraft factory, but fortunately, it looks like we'll be seeing Red Comet. So I wonder what the thought process is for Steel Blue choosing Red Comet. Maybe some sort of rush? Maybe he's going to try and scorch a rush. Since it seemed to have worked last time. Maybe he thinks that's his best bet. Played an okay long game, really. I'm not sure how, honestly. I'm not sure how he stayed in such a long game with Google Frog, but he did, nonetheless. So you might honestly try that again. Doesn't seem to be the case here. I think we're going to see just another Scorcher dive if my radar is on. Just waiting for the game to start up here. I was so impressed with that last game, though. I mean... Google Frog's use of like the Thunderbird and the Napalm Bomber was super impressive, but the way Steel Blue was able to just hang in there somehow and get those, like, you know, those few clutch engagements to stay in time and time again.
Well, like I said, they're at an advantage for most of the game. That helped.
Yeah.
Like, taking that North expansion really gave them a lot to work with.
Yeah, it really did. Definitely, I underestimated that.
Right, so the next game is going to be Red Comet.
Yeah. I think might be seeing some fine dairy products here.
That's the only reason I can think why Steel Blue would even think to go for this.
Yeah. So probably some Scorchers, I would imagine. I hope he doesn't, I don't know. If he does the Rocket Comm thing again, I hope that he balls the Scorchers. Just waits until he builds a critical mass and then dives.
Yeah.
You know, if you're going to cheese, you should execute it well. And breaking up your pack of raiders before you even get your rocket commander there is just bad cheese form, I guess.
Yes. Well, I mean, it worked against Failthoss, but that was even close. And that was on a much smaller map. And it looks like Steel Blue is playing it more straight.
Yeah. Huh. Yeah. You might be going for the long game in this light vehicle mirror on Red Comet.
I mean, I guess I could see that, but I don't know where they can get an easy advantage in Red Comet.
Yeah,
I guess
think
Northwest. I don't know.
I just you know what? I'm gonna stop making predictions because I was nearly wrong on my last one.
Nearly, yeah. That was if it weren't for the fact that the Napalm Bomber and the Thunderbird, or the Phoenix and Thunderbird, if they weren't left unattended, you would have been wrong.
Yep, no doubt about it.
You would have been very wrong.
A little embarrassed.
It would have been Google Frog's map pick, not Steel Blue's.
That's right.
I mean, I think it would have been 2-1 in that case for Google Frog, but still. Steel Blue would have taken the game. But they were darn close, as it was. So at least we know they don't have to cheese.
That's right.
They just need to work a little bit more on their attention. Which is a really hard thing to do. Like, that's one of the hardest things to get right. Is attentiveness.
I don't know. Well, so he's got the 3 Scorchers up there hanging out at his base. Yeah, it looks like he is going to be playing straight. Mm-hmm. But he built this early constructor last time too. Oh, I didn't even see. He has a support commander, so certainly not going to do any sort of rocket cheese.
Probably a beam laser.
Yeah, alright, so it looks like a long game.
Yeah, another long game, and this time in Red Comet, which is definitely not the longest of long game maps.
Yeah, not traditionally a very long game map at all.
Well, I mean, long-ish game, like 10-15 minutes probably.
Sure.
Like, 22 minutes in Wanderlust is not unheard of.
Yeah.
Just the way the choke points are laid out.
Mm-hmm.
This one doesn't have as much in the way of choke points, but I've seen some long ones on this. Let's see, though. Steel Blue in a nice position, too. I mean, got a bit flanked, but didn't... didn't hammer much. Google Frog's commander's open.
See, that was the time to dive. It was a level zero commander. All he had was the pea shooter. He needed to grab him before he gets that riot cannon.
No, go, go!
Go, go! Like,
Steel Blue, I mean, I realize you're not watching, even if you are, there's a delay, so you won't see this in time, but... Stream sniping will not help you, but still.
Painful to watch.
Go north!
He could still do it. Just pretty much at any point until the Scorcher's engaged, he could have dove.
Yeah. Now we're too weak. And even then he could still dive, or they could still dive, because they still have four.
Just needs to regroup and go for it. I don't know. I think his window's closed at this point.
Oh, no, I disagree. I think the window's still open. Oh, never mind. Scorchers are damaged. And Scorchers are way too damaged. Well, the window for base dive is way open.
Oh, you're right. Well, fresh Scorchers coming out of the factory will stop him.
Oh, never mind. His defender, too.
Just delayed too long. He did everything right. He got the Scorchers perfectly into position, and then he did nothing with
them. And also, factory idle.
Oh, no. That's not a good start. It's too bad. It could have been so good for him.
That could have done the game, too. Like, that could have won the game.
That seriously,
like, kill the commander, especially if the Scorchers survive.
Yeah.
Then...
Almost certainly would have ended it, but...
Yeah, then go around from the north, take out the metal extractors, take out the factory. Game three.
Missed opportunities, though. Both players pushing pretty aggressively with their commanders here. I think this is kind of a risky move with the support commander. There's no Scorchers around here to help defend it, and it looks like he's still level zero. Really... He just needs to get unlucky with Google scouting his comm, and, he could very much be in the same position.
I don't even think luck's going to play into it. I think Google Frog's going to scout, realize the comm's not there, figure, well, it's an econ comm, so it's going to go forward, because I've checked north.
Mm-hmm.
The only way that it would be safe is if it was far northwest. That's the only place it would be safe. Like, Google Frog would look there last.
Hmm.
Because now Google Frog sees, oh, well, the expansion's not the north, the expansion must be to the southeast, because there must be an expansion.
That's the thing.
There's going to have to be one, so it's got to be either north or east.
Two LTs slept just in time. A level zero commander, though, definitely could use a beam laser. But it does look like the Scorchers will get pushed back, so nice hold.
That was, but it was way too close for comfort.
It was risky, yep. Both players definitely in significant danger, but both able to avoid without any injury.
Yeah. The only difference is that Google Frog has a better idea of what they can afford to risk.
Mm-hmm.
Steel Blue is being a little bit risk-averse.
Yep, absolutely.
Which at this point, they don't really have the luxury of doing so.
He needs these Scorchers to be forward and applying pressure. See, what he's doing, it looks like keeping his Scorchers back to help defend against raids. Instead, I think he needs to be applying pressure to control where his enemy's army has to be. Force your opponent to defend where your army's at instead of, you know, placing your army to try and hope that you'll catch theirs.
Yeah, unless you're using low mobility forces, there's no reason to... Actually, in both cases, I guess. Low mobility forces even more so, because you'd want to pull them into the low mobility forces.
Yes. Exactly. We are seeing a bit more aggressive here with these Scorchers.
Well, they have seven Scorchers now. They can just rush in. They can tear this apart directly.
I think he's open for a dive again at this point. Oh, no, it's morphed to level one now. But
is it Riot Cannon? It's Riot Cannon. Nope, there's no way.
Sure it is. So, but he could absolutely raid out with a force like this. Oh, early Ravagers from Google Frog. That's a bit of a gambit, in my opinion, building assault so early with raiders out on the field like this.
Yeah, that's... I don't know why Google Frog's doing that.
I don't understand the logic here. I mean, maybe just trying to build a mid-game composition early, but it's too greedy. And I feel like Steel Blue might make it in here to punish
him
for it.
Steel Blue is going to be able to punish. There's the Stardust, but that's taking too long.
Won't be built in time, of course.
It's a good distraction, though. It did manage to kill one of the cause one of the Scorchers to die because of the Ravager.
Yeah. And look at that. These Scorchers actually won't pick up any of the Ravagers, so...
No, because they were way too worried about the Stardust. And now another Stardust is coming up.
Baited into the leveler, too. So, really, really well played there by Google Frog.
Yeah, that was tricky. Because it's easy to get tunnel vision in that particular case, and that's... Well, that was kind of the end there. And the Stinger is not going to be up in time. Levelers and Ravagers... Actually, are they... Oh, it is! They're not moving. Oh, there, never mind. It's nowhere near up in time. That leveler, if the leveler dies, there's a small chance, like a really small chance, and that's now a zero chance.
Slimmer and slimmer, as that sentence went on.
I can't actually finish the sentence without the chance becoming zero, or so close to zero as to be indistinguishable from it. Like, you had to be struck by lightning once, twice, five times while winning the lottery, twice, three times. Okay, you're just dead. Let me finish my sentence before you start making the odds go against whoever I'm thinking the odds are for. Yeah, that stinger's down. One Raptor at best. Oh, manages to help get two with the commander support. But yeah. One Raptor exactly, and then the commander not going to be too heavily damaged here. I mean, Google Frog, they're basically just playing it patient. Like, going in, killing a few, running out, repairing. Going in, killing a few, running out, repairing.
Yeah. Well, I mean, if he's already working on building his late game composition, that's the way to do it with these heavier units. Just sort of poke in, repair, and keep doing that. You'll eventually whittle down Steel Blue. Well,
Steel Blue's commander. Sheesh. Maybe Beam Laser Nanolith. Oh, no, just Nanolith. Pure Nanolith. We're still on Pea Shooter.
Still on Pea Shooter? No. No, this... Oh, what is he doing? Oh, well.
Yeah? Well, it doesn't matter now.
But yeah, that was a blunder.
Yeah, that was a Pea Shooter commander.
Ugh,
no
that didn't make
weapons.
Any sense.
Yeah. At all.
See, I don't have any modules. I just have the 150 metal beam laser, which is really all you need for a 1v1. Morph it to level 1.
Yeah, exactly. Get a nice moving LLT.
Yeah, exactly. Oh well, that's unfortunate. That was such a good showing in the first game, but it looks like we're going to see a Google Frog 2-0 here.
Yeah, it looks like they're talking about... So, I guess they're... Oh, I see. They're talking about Svadilfok.
Oh.
In the chat, saying that Svadilfok is really powerful, but doesn't really care.
It was quite the topic of conversation among, the 1v1 veterans. Because it's so perplexing. He's such a teams player. But then he beats these, really impressive 1v1 players all the time. Or at least with some reasonable frequency.
Well, it's just... The macro game is handled well.
Yes.
And the defense of that is handled well.
And if you don't win fast enough, macro will beat you.
Yeah.
And Svadilfok definitely has good macro. Quite the engagement in the center here. Definitely favorite Google Frog's Ravagers, unless they end up getting kited. But no, it looks like they'll be picking it apart. I really love
Steel
how he's sort of
panicking.
Yeah, and you saw there how Google Frog moved his Ravagers to sort of pick on the one Steel Blue Ravager that had sort of gotten away from the pack. That sort of little tiny micro, during the engagements is going to pretty easily allow Google Frog to move in through the south here.
Well, Steel Blue, I think, is really falling behind. As you can see, Google Frog taking the north. They didn't lose the south. I mean, they lost one south expansion, but idle. Steel Blue's keeping it idle. There's one thing I could recommend to Steel Blue is get in the habit of bouncing between everything you have. If you're not control grouping, control group like mad. You need those. Yeah. And then bounce between control groups all the time.
Yes.
And get your APM up that way. Even if it's nothing's happening, just get your APM up by constantly bouncing between them.
Yeah.
And jump into camera between them.
Even if all you can do are like rough move orders on the minimap or whatever with your control group, at least do something with them. You know, like these Scorchers down here in the bottom east, like these could run up and at least gut out two more metal extractors or head up through the north.
They could gut out five metal extractors if they're careful.
If they were... Exactly. If they were careful about it, there's quite a bit of potential here. Now they're on the move, but
now they're being spotted too.
Exactly. So much earlier, they actually would have worked out just a few seconds ago. Yeah, too late.
As Hokomoka puts it, which
too
is
late
very
indeed.
Apt. And if they retreat, they have a chance.
Mm-hmm.
But they're not even retreating well enough. They got caught in the crater.
Look at this.
Oh, nice. One of them actually. Oh, not quite. I thought one of them managed to tear away from the rest, but no, it didn't. Not effectively.
Very nearly. This is a pretty intimidating looking Ravager Ball on the west side. Steel Blue doesn't really have an answer for it, right? He has his own Ball of Ravagers, but we've seen how the micro has gone so far. Google Frog has his own Scorchers, which are going to type counter the Ravagers. Oh, Google Frog has his T-Bird up as well. He's coming to help out in just a moment, I'm sure.
Yeah, because why not? Two of them, for good measure.
Sure.
That was a good thing to have in the vehicle matchup.
Oh, here we go. Coming in for the shot. Oh,
well,
a little
solar
bit off.
Plants?
I guess
the lotuses.
The solar plants definitely won't be dealing any damage.
Yeah, so, I mean, you know how dangerous those things are.
Right, the DPS is.
Have you ever seen a unit go inside one of those things when someone else hits it? It's dead. Instant death.
So these Scorchers could probably dive in. be a bit more effective. Maybe he's worried about splash from the Ravagers.
Yeah, well, actually, the Ravager, also the Thunderbird. Don't want to stun out their own forces. That would be suicide.
Ah, yeah. I see.
That would be a problem.
He was waiting for the T-Bird to come through. Scorcher's now coming around the backside. This is pretty open, too. Wow, this Fence of Solars is actually working against Steel Blue as these Ravagers bottleneck on the way through it.
Yeah, that's always the tricky thing about whenever you have any blocking is just...
Yeah.
If you have it against a wall that's on this... so that you're on the same side as your factory.
Yes.
But otherwise...
You don't want to move through it.
No.
If you're in a situation where you have to defend, like, you want your opponent to move through and himself be bottlenecked, but you don't want to bottleneck yourself on your own Solars, for sure.
Yeah, and in a position like this, it's almost impossible to avoid bottlenecking because you don't know which side your opponent's going to be on.
Yes.
Yeah, Google Frog played that well, went to the side that would cause the most bottlenecking for Steel Blue.
Yep.
And now at this point, Steel Blue is basically dead. I mean, Google Frog has 4 times the military. They have four times the
Look
economy.
At this.
They're just
a wyvern coming up through the middle of the map. I don't really know
why
you needed a wyvern. Yeah, I guess why not? And it was Icy to nuke the 2 Wolverines, which I usually use wyverns for that myself.
Yeah. Well, that is game and match. So Google Frog moves on to the the grand finals rather.
Hmm.
Congratulations. So congratulations, Steel Blue, you got third.
Not a bad showing at all. Really.
No, I don't disagree with that. Like I was a little annoyed because it's like, wow, geez. I wonder if someone's going to suggest best of three losers pre-finals, but then Steel Blue proved that no, they're okay. They're not just cheese.
Not just cheese.